Okay, so in this video we are going to create a chart of sales revenue using data that's been generated over time. We're going to create a trend line. We're going to forecast the trend for 3 months into the future. We're going to identify any seasonal variations within our data, and we're going to record some forecasted values. So firstly, we have got a series of data here, sales data. We can see we start in January 2015, and that's how much our sales are. And it goes down on a month by month basis down to June 2017. To start out with, I'm just going to add a couple of more months. So that's going to be the 3 months we're going to forecast. We could make more months. I'm just going to make it 3 in this particular video. So the first thing we wanted to do is to do a chart. So to get a better sort of graphical overview of this data here. So let's include these months where we got the data from. So highlight all of the data for the particular month with all the dates in. Click insert and that recommended chart and choose the bar chart. That's a good starting point. Doesn't have to be this, just like it because it's beautiful. And now we sort of got our data like this. We can see on a month by month basis how our sales have progressed. So a neat little feature in Excel is this feature called forecast. And what we can do is we can try and sort of get some sort of idea of how this data sort of develops in a nice sort of graphical line. So go into any of the bars, right click on them and say add a trend line. And here we get a number of different choices to trend lines. And we could choose one that sort of we feel fits our data the best. A typical line is the linear trend line. That's sort of the most used trend line is very often used. But there are a number of different options here that you can choose to use. And we can see they always sort of comes out to something very different apart from this moving average. I'm choosing logarithmic because it seems like it's a pretty good fit for what is actually happening. So one thing to notice is if we go down here, we can actually forecast this trend line into, in this case, I want 3 periods, and a period is sort of each of these on month. So we're going to try and forecast this for 3 months. Again, we could do it for more. I'm just choosing 3 months for the purpose of this example. So put in 3 and then close this down here. Now we got this forecast in here. What's interesting about the forecast is that we can use that to actually see where we think the next few months at what they would be. Before we start talking about that, I'd quite like to just add a few more lines here so it becomes clearer what data is. So I'm going to right click out here and decide. On the x-axis here, so right click and add minor grid lines just to get it a bit more easy to see. Anyway, let's talk about seasonal variations. So we know that over at different times of year, businesses tend, or at least some businesses that's particularly influenced by seasonal variations, increase or decrease their sales. So let's look at December. December tends to be a busy month. So we've got the 1st December here. And if we look at the trend line, where it's not our average, but it's sort of a similar idea, we can actually see in December that our sales is quite a lot above that average, or not average, let's be clear. It's not an average, but it's sort of a similar idea, our trend here. So there's clearly a boom month in December. Let's go to next December. Again, if our trend is here, it's quite a lot above. Okay, so December is clearly a boom month compared to our trend period. So are there any periods where they're doing particularly worse than the trend? Well, we can see there's a real big gap here in June and July. So that's clearly bad months for this particular business. What about the next June and July? Again, quite a lot below the trend. So when it comes for us to forecast in July, it would make sense to actually say that we're actually we can see again here June is quite a bit below, and as before with July, we would expect that to also be a bit below. So for July, it would be sort of reasonable to think that it's going to be around, say, 575, so 5,750,000 would be a reasonable figure. August, we can see August here is a bit above our trend line. Next August, again, a bit above the trend line. So it'd be reasonable to think that August would be a bit above the trend line, which in this case would be about 500, say, is it 600? Yeah, in fact, it'll probably be a little bit above 600. So let's say 600, 6 million, or 6 million, I mean. So let's see what that looks like. And September seems to be pretty bang on the trend line. So here's, well, a little bit over the trend line. So it might be that it's going to be a little bit higher than the trend line. So let's see what that looks like. So if we click out here on the side, we can now sort of include all of these new numbers we've added. So actually, I quite like my. So it sort of looks fairly alright with June and July, but August and September, I'd like to be a little bit higher, sort of above that trend line. So it'd be reasonable, maybe if we say 200 here. And September, let's say 650. Yeah, that seems about right. So what we now got is we forecast the 3 months. It could have been more. We've done it in considering seasonal variations. So we've done it considering the trend that we build up as well. Would you think, do you agree with those numbers? Do they seem realistic? Or I'll leave that down to you to ponder.